Thank you for the introduction and for all, to, all of you. So, following with data pathologies, I'm going to explain another pathology, and I'm going to talk about how to detect TNCS for crystallographic phasing. But first, let me to explain what is TNCS. So, it stands for translational non-crystallographic symmetry and arises when the symmetric unit contains two or more copies that are oriented in the same way and can be superimposed by a translation that does not correspond to any symmetry operation in the space group. So this is really frequent in macromolecular structures, and the, more or less the 8% of the structures in the PDB has TNCS. So this causes a really big effect in the data that is going to give us an overall modulation with systematically strong and systematically weak intensities. So in general cases, cases without TNCS, the contribution of the atoms from symmetry-related molecules are independent. But on the other hand, in cases with TNCS, for certain reflection values, and depending on the translation vector, the contribution of the related atoms can have the same or opposite phase. So this happens because when the translationally related molecules scatter in phase, they interfere constructively, so the reflections are stronger. And if they scatter out of phase, they are going to interfere destructively, so the reflection will be weaker. So we can see here an example of two molecules that are related by a translation vector in the vertical lattice of almost one half. And we can see here in the diffraction pattern that the eighth index even are stronger for, well, in comparison with the eighth index odd. So this is easy to understand in an extreme situation when we have the translation vector of one half. And in this case, the eighth index of reflection will completely disappear, and the unit cell becomes the half of the size. So we can see also this effect in the in the amplitude distribution, because when we have a structure without TNCS, it follows the amplitude distribution will follow the well-known Wilson distribution. And in the cases with the TNCS that is indicated with the blue dots, this distribution is broader than for a normal crystal. So as this overall modulation of the intensities changes the statistics, and as earlier explained before, with the maximum likelihood methods that are used in molecular replacement, we need an accurate statistical model, and we need also to take into account this statistical effect of TNCS. So as the likelihood targets also for phasing and for refinement assumes that all the intensities, and more important, the errors in predicting the intensities from the model follow a Wilson distribution and not this broad distribution that I showed you before. So phaser is going to perform a correction for the statistical effect of TNCS. So the objective of our study is to find an optimal way to characterize TNCS so it can be accounted for. So in the first place, we're going to determine if the structure has TNCS or not, and then if it has it, we're going to determine the TNCS order, that are how many molecules are related by any translation vector. So we are, need to determine as well the number of different TNCS vectors. So it could happen that in some cases, several hypotheses for TNCS might be ranked equally high, in which case the user will be guided to proceed with each hypothesis independently. And the importance of this study is that maybe if TNCS is not detected, a structural solution might fail. So depending on the type of TNCS that the crystal has, the TNCS correction factors that are going to be applied will differ. So we have three groups: the pairs of molecules, the higher the TNCS, and the complex TNCS. So in the first situation, we've got a pairs of molecules that are related by a translation vector, and this is not a perfect translation, but rather a translation combined with a small rotation, typically less than 10 degrees. So we need to find these values and then refine their values against the likelihood function. So there are the small rotational difference in their orientation, the translation vector relating the copies, and the size of random coordinate differences caused by conformational differences, and in other words, the RMSD between the copies. So in the second situation, we have a TNCS order greater than 2 that are more than 2 molecules related by multiples of the same vector. So here we've got an example of a TNCS order of 4. So in this case, we are going only to refine these 2 parameters, the translation and the RMSD between the copies. And that is because as if we got more molecules, the rotational differences between the copies and the resulting intensities intensity modulations becomes less significant. So this, simplification is justified. So in the third situation, we found TNCS-related copies by vectors in different directions. So here, the modulation of the intensities will be much less significant, and maybe it's possible that a structure solution will be achieved without any TNCS correction being applied. But before we can correct these TNCS factors, we need to know if the structure has TNCS or not. And as Eleanor explained this morning, the Patterson function can be calculated from the measured intensities alone and revealed interatomic vectors in a structure. So if you have 2 copies that are related by TNCS, each atom is related to itself in the other copy by the same translation vector. So we'll fall in the top of each other, giving a peak, a peak of a significant percentage of the origin peak, that is a larger peak. So in phase, this TNCS is detected calculating the Patterson map with data from 5 to 10 angstroms and then finding a strong peak in the Patterson of over 20% and at more than 15 angstroms from the origin. So to accomplish the objective of the study, the first time is to test these parameters in a systematic way in order to choose the best ones of resolution range, percentage of the origin peak, and distance from the origin. So in order to make this study, we preliminarily choose a subset of 20 structures where all calculations were manually curated. So we then moved to the big data set of 90,000 structures, and as there are a lot of structures, we truncate data to 3 angstroms in order to save runtime. And also we remove from this database some structures with errors in the data, some modulated structures as can be nucleic acid, coil coils, or collagen, and the non-protein structures as antibiotics. And we end up with a final database of almost 79,000 structures. So with this database, we're going to perform two kinds of studies, the coordinate analysis and the data analysis. So with the coordinate analysis, we determine depending on the degree of rotational differences, if the structure has TNCS or not, and also the TNCS order. And we determine with this analysis as well the shortest Patterson vector distance that, as I said you, the current threshold for this distance to the origin is 15 angstroms. And so that the shortest distance reported with less than 10 degrees of rotational tolerance is 21.6 angstroms from this structure. So we can say that this threshold for distance to the origin is safe. So then for the data analysis, as we know for the previous analysis, if the structure has TNCS or not, depending of the rotational tolerances, we divide it into 2 groups, and we find in the data the highest non-origin Patterson peak, that is the one at more than 15 angstroms from the origin. So in the cases with no TNCS, we can see in these histograms that the majority of the cases has a peak of less than 20 degrees, and in the cases with TNCS, this peak, well, in the lowest rotational tolerances, since the majority of the cases have a peak of over this 20%. But for this 15 and 20, we can see here that are a lot of structures that has a peak of less than 20. So that means that the data here is less modulated. So thanks to this both analysis, we perform an algorithm that is a decision tree. And a decision tree is a predictive modeling approach that will use in statistic, data mining, and machine learning. So we're going to assign the Patterson highest non-origin peak to, to a value that's yes or not for the TNCS. So we're going to divide our data set in the training set and in the test set. So this training set is going to have these two values, and it's going to be used in order to train our algorithm for then test it with this test set that is going to be blind in principle for these values. So the algorithm is going to predict if the structure has TNCS or not, and then we'll check with the real values, and we'll put all these values in a confusion matrix saying the true positives, true negatives, false positives, and false negatives. And with these values, it's going to calculate the accuracy of the algorithm. So here we are, the decision tree results for different resolution ranges and for the assignment of yes, TNCS or not at different rotational tolerances. So in general, the accuracy of the of our algorithm is quite high, and we can see also as the stricter the TNCS is, I mean the less rotational different has is favored by the use of the highest resolution data and not this 510 that is used by default. So we need also to take a look into the outliers, I mean the false positives and the false negatives, because an structure can have low peaks but could have a TNCS. So we're going to manually inspect the Patterson and also the shape of the peaks, because can, for example, has can have a partial or complex TNCS, and maybe it is not necessary to perform any correction to this data in order to could have solved the structure. And could happen as well that the structure have a big peaks in the Patterson but has no TNCS. So we're going to calculate the Patterson, the ideal data from the coordinates, in order to see if these peaks are real or not. Because here we've got an interesting example that with real data there is a peak of over the 20% of the origin and at this distance, and with ideal data this this peak doesn't exist, so could happen in more cases. And we are going also to check for other pathologies as twinning, anisotropy, or ice rings. And as a summary, in order to get our optimal way to characterize TNCS for then apply these TNCS correction factors to solve the structures, we perform a database curation, and with this database we perform a coordinate and a data analysis, and we determine that if the structure has TNCS or not at different rotational tolerances, and we determine as well that the current threshold for distance to the origin of 15 angstroms is safe, and we also calculate the highest non-origin Patterson peak at different resolutions. So with all this value, we train an algorithm that is going to give us the possibility of having TNCS and use this possibility to rank all the possibilities. But, we still have to improve the determination of the TNCS order. And I would like to thank especially Erlie McCoy, that she is the supervisor of this study, and all the FACER group, Massimo, Randy, and Rob, and all of you, and also Pavel Anfonin, that he makes some scripts, and all my entire group, the Archimboldo team, and Isabel Uzon, that she's my supervisor, and CCP for and the CCP for organizers for giving me the opportunity to give this talk.